history of the state of Maine, has been sentenced to 4 years in prison. A judge in
too much money, I think. And so, if you don't, it's different, but it's cheaper. across the U.S. participate each year, they say it's a good way to introduce new material to fans and those who are new to the comic book world. In Harvard Square, shows home to BBC News Radio 1030.
WBZ's Time 126, Rhode Island Governor Gina Raimondo is ordering state agencies to step up their commitment to people with mental health and substance abuse problems. The governor signed an executive order calling for an action plan to improve the state's behavioral and mental health care systems. The order also directs agencies to review how insurance companies are treating mental and behavioral health needs. WBZ's Time 126.
Let's talk about Blake Crouch's latest best-selling novel, Dark Matter. It's a book of what-ifs, and boy, is it a lot of fun. A run-of-the-mill professor, Jason Dessen, goes out for ice cream one night, only to be abducted, finding himself strapped to a gurney in a high-tech lab, where some man he doesn't know says, "Welcome back, my friend." In this new world he's woken up to, Jason's life is not the one he knows. His wife is not his wife, his son was never born, and Jason is not some ordinary college physics professor, but a celebrated genius who's achieved something incredible. By now you've probably figured out that physics, and particularly quantum and string theory, are very much at work here. Pseudoscience and science fiction together bring us to a story that features our hero battling dozens of himself, other Jasons, mostly with the same intent, but many willing to kill to return to their home existence. It is one massive sci-fi chase scene, and it's a lot of fun. Dark Matter by Blake.